Hi, it's Maaike. I wanted to show you a little bit of my craft room. I changed a few things since the one I did 2 years ago. Not much, but it's an ongoing process, of course. So I do this a little bit on my camera so I can actually see if I'm in screen. And then I will switch to my other camera, which I use for filming, and do a voiceover probably. Bye. Yeah, sorry, this is my Scanicat Nuc next to my two wardrobes that don't fit in my bedroom anymore because I switched this master bedroom for craft room, and this is a hole for an outlet, and my cat fit in there, and I lost him once and he was hiding in the closet. I've been looking for him for 2 days. No, that's not true, 2 hours I think. But this is my happy wall. I need a better solution for that because all the cards keep falling off. And my filming desk, my computer desk, you see all the stuff that people have, you know, it's not really big. My Billy's, most of my stuff is from IKEA, and I'm trying to move slowly, but this camera is new for me. This is a small Billy. That's half the size. So I put it upside down so I can put it on my desk, and it has my pencils and the, you know, gumshoe stuff that you use, and my markers. And half my markers are gone because I swapped them for Copics with a friend, but not all Copics are back in here yet because I need to buy refills and brush nibs and stuff for them. I already bought 70 € worth of brush nibs, and I need 42 refills. So yeah, that might take a while. So yeah, that's my desk, and they do look pretty clean. But if you look closely, you can see stuff on the floor and everything because, you know, bending down is not my hobby. This is actually an Antonius drawer organization from IKEA. I'm not sure I still have them. It's a few years old, but they fit ink pads really well. By now it's become a catch-all for stuff that shouldn't be on my desk, and once in a while I empty it and see what's in there. There's scotch tape runners and stuff like that, all the things that you need. I use the Spectrum Noir trays for my markers. They also fit other brands. So yeah, as I say, it used to be completely full, but the illustrator have gone to a friend and I got her Copics for that. And they're not all in here yet. They're in one of those wardrobes that I showed you earlier because they don't work, and I don't want to keep, you know, getting them out and find out, oh yeah, that one was dry. So I keep it separate. And the boxes are also from IKEA. They don't sell them anymore in this size, which is a shame. And the baskets are from a dollar store kind of store, an Action in the Netherlands or in Europe. And the top one has my last bit of 6x6 paper that is left, and three baskets full of stamps and dies for Christmas. And you see that this shelf has the Carlijn Design DT stamps and pre-cut watercolor base and stuff like that, and four empty baskets because it used to house my 6x6 paper and also my colored cardstock that I have put in an old drawer. And then this has four, it fits four baskets properly, but the one is with Lily of the Valley and small stamps, and then 24 Weeks of Christmas. The blue one has new, and the next one as well that I think I want to film with or not, and I haven't put them away in the proper filing system that's below. That's ABC because I store them by brand. See, the Sunny Studio is in front. I already used that. I should put them in the S, of course. I haven't done that yet. And yeah, as I said, below is everything is sorted by brands. So Art Impressions A and K for Quetzalcraft. MFT. Some brands have their own tab, like Simon System, because I have a lot of those, and MFT as well, and Quetzalcraft, by the way. And then on the bottom there's 6x6 or more like texture stamps that I use for mixed media and ATC coins, stencils, and two empty baskets. In one I just put my heat guns for now, because they were empty. And that's because I destressed the 6x6 paper blocks, and my linen cardstock are now in a different spot. And I tried walking backwards without making you sick, but even I'm getting a little bit. See, this is a metal drawer chest that I have for 30 years, I think. And it did have colored card in there, but it was more like printer paper quality, very thin, and I didn't like it for crafting. So I gave those away to someone who wanted them and put my proper cardstock, I would say, in there, which I use for die cutting. Then it's more sturdy. And you can see shoes on the floor, grip bags, don't look at that. I spend most of my time here, so the room has been growing for 30 years or maybe longer. I mean, I'm turning 50 this year. I've been crafting for a long time, and not everything is color coded, because I do use and reuse and stuff that are around the house, like those red and pink chests that you see. They were supposed to be for plants. Now there's craft store, and most of them are empty actually. And the drawers, the blue and the pink one, they lived in my bathroom for a while. You know, they had toothpicks in there, and toothpaste and brushes and stuff for your ears and all those elastic bands and everything you need. But I put everything in these see-through organizers there for shoes, I believe. And then I put paper in the front so it doesn't look too messy. But some boxes are empty, you could fit more, and they take up more room than necessary probably. But if I want sequins, I can just take the whole box with me. If I want glitter, I can take the box out, and I don't have to carry 20 things in my hands that will drop. And if you ever drop sequins or glitter, you know you don't want to do that. And then my Ecoline card bases are actually for card kits that I got. There's only one in there now. I think it's from Simon System. And I won that from a grab bag. And the embellishments, I got rid of most of my fake flowers in the same people that I gave all the other things to. But yeah, there's a little bit of stickers on there and breads and maybe more stuff that can go. But for now, see, that one is empty. There was pigment in there, and they were drying up. So I put them in with my Bursa Magic dewdrop thingy, so I might use them more. And refills for distress inks and Versa Magic and Versafine, stuff like that. Hotfix also has quilling paper in there, and a quilling mat that I still need to master. I used it once in I need more practice. One of our DT members, Quillish, she uses that a lot on her cards, and it looks so great. I wanted to use it or try to use them. And this is a bit of a hot mess. I might put them in that empty box that was up there. All my palettes and Ecolina trays and Wood Mountain stamps are in there, in the thing below the sorry. There's my dice and a box with foil that is not heat sensitive. I also have those from Fab Foil and Wow. They're in a different part. And then these are magazine organizers that hold stuff like my craft paper and glitter paper, or craft foam, sorry, and tissue paper. A few blocks that I should have given away as well, and I never used them. Might still do that. See, this is tissue paper and some of that tool thing that I bought because I saw Jennifer McGuire make a shaker card and I wanted to try it and I haven't yet. So I like my acetate. But this is glitter, and I put them all in these pouches for documents. We call them L-shaped document holders because they're open. on two sides. And I just sort them by color and then put everything in there. There's mirror card and also holographic card, but mostly glitter. And if I want one color, I can just pull it out. And if I don't want anything, I'll just put it back. And yeah, sorry, I didn't vacuum. I didn't really clean it, just so you know, this is how my craft room looks more like. There might be cat candy on the floor and there's hair on the window curtain dressing things. They are white and my cats are black, so they will always show up. And also on my table, I can see or now I dusted just a few days ago and now it's full of cat hair again. It's but yeah, I love my cats, so I will enjoy this. And on top you can see cardboard boxes. The two in the corner have my office bills and stuff that I need to keep for tax purposes, you know, for 7 years, and then I never look at them, so I don't sort them anymore as I used to do, because that takes up way too much work and nobody wants to look in them ever, so neither do I, and I will just throw them away after 7 years. So see, these are the little plant pots. They're not really meant for plants, but that's where I put them in. And some are still empty, some have beads in them, some have my stuff that I should throw away, because there's baby oil and Spectrum Noir refills for my markers that have evaporated. But yeah, bottles are not airtight, I guess. And then the baby oil, someone suggested that for pencil. I didn't like it, so it lives in there. I never use it. So probably next bins to be reorganized. And then the gold leafing stuff, and there's also silver. There's a few things in there, but most of them. And then I also have a box for that, for my mixed media pastes. And this is a bit hard with one hand, but it has really old pencils in there. And my do you call it compass? Not sure. To draw circles. That was from school. That was 1985. So I still have it. And this was full of little punches, and I gave those away as well. I only kept the basic shapes, like a heart and corners. And then these are the water brush markers that I use to make my own watercolor markers. They work, but they leak a little bit, so they have to live in here, so they don't leak all over the place. And distress sprays and paints. And then there's a basket that has a bit of that light stuff, you know, that you used to make light up cards, but also other things that just end up in there. I'll go through it later, kind of thing. Yeah, so there you can see the copper tape and the foil tape, and there's bags of limes and yeah, not stuff that you use a lot, so they get compounded in one area. My cutting plates. And these drawers, as I said, they used to live in my bathroom. They had pencils in there. I gave those to a friend that was just starting out coloring, and she bought those really cheap ones that don't give color off at all. And then some of the stuff I use for my WoW bonded melting projects. Perfect pearls and shine pearls, which is a different brand for the same things. And the brushes that go with it, that could go in the same drawer probably, and I would have an empty drawer again. And little pots for if I make my own embossing mixes. And these are my embossing powders. Most of them are from WoW, which I love. And I have them sorted. This is the metallics drawer. It says there, you can't read it, but it says metallics. And then it has primaries, which is just plain ones, but colored ones. Also white and clear and glow in the dark is actually my windowsill at the moment, but it would live in here as well. I'm trying to see if I can charge it better, you know. And then this glitter, and I sorted them by blue and green tones, so cold colors. See, pretty. And I make a little heart swatch for the top, so I know what color it is. And this is the warm tones, and I also have a swatch book because most of the powders are transparent, so I know what it looks like on a dark surface. I have my book for that. There's a video if you're interested. And this is some craft foam I was given that doesn't want to stay in that basket. And then there's this really cheap, I think, back sealer. And I thought maybe I can use it as a fuse tool to make shaker pouches. But I'm still looking for a plastic that might work. And this is a retro metal box that houses my camera and my microphone for when I'm filming. I take it out and I put it on my desk, but when I don't, I put it in here. You can't see, but I have to pull it out halfway just to get my camera out. It's a bit annoying, but I don't have room elsewhere. I'm pondering on a place, but that's too much cat frequented. It has to be safe. And then there's my laminator, of course, some tape, and then this is the box with my nail art residue from when I did my and other people's nails. And I put them all in here because they're perfect for shaker cards. And well, these are not per se for nails, but I thought they wouldn't be nice in shaker cards as well. But there's, yeah, little wheels with all kinds of shiny stuff like this. And you can buy them everywhere. I mean, the nail art things, every duck store has them. So when I see something just like washi tapes, I will just buy it because, oh, I don't have that color. Although I have enough washi tape for the next lifetime, I think. And then there's a little basket with my coins and stuff that were given with trades. And these little drawers, I have the homemade enamel dots. I threw them away. They were melted beads, but yeah, they're not as perfect as I would have liked, so they are gone. And I also kept the rhinestones and the, you know, sticky beads, and gave half of those away as well to the same people that got all the other bits. And it's, they go first to a friend of mine, and she gives them to people that craft for the church, and then they sell their crafts, and with the sales they buy schools in Africa. So I thought that was a good cause. And on the bottom there's boxes with acrylic paint and fixatives and stuff. And I want to try acrylic pouring, so every time I buy a little bit. And I was given lots of acrylic paint, but those are those, I say, called chalky paints. Not sure they work for crafting like acrylic pouring, but we'll see. And then there's a box of, I don't know what. There used to be paints in there, and there's a splatter box, some aluminium trays, and there's, see, that's my office administration. We called it administratie, which, you know, you just have to keep the bills. I already paid them, but I need to keep them for 7 years, and don't worry. But yeah, jelly plate, those knives. Yeah, I don't know what they're called today. I have a brain meltdown. Pencils and brushes, and a little pot of yogurt actually has beads that I use for my ring card. And these are from Lidl, actually for screws and stuff, but they fit perfectly for washi tapes. And these three are empty. They used to have beads and buttons, and well, guess what I did with those? Those people were very happy with all my stuff. And I never used buttons anymore. I mean, I haven't used them in 5-6 years, so I figured, you know, yeah, they'll probably be big again next year and I don't have any buttons. But this is a basket that has full sheets of marker paper and watercolor paper and stuff that I don't want to stand up because they will bend in the middle, so that they lay flat in the box. And another box with my glue gun, and also the stem positioners that we never use anymore. I should have given that away as well and not drop everything. And there's also silicone mats and, you know, stuff for your glue gun. cartridges, my project in progress bin, and then a Be Creative Craft bin. I would say the DT team that has a bit of a hiatus, so well, they live in there. And boxes on the bottom that I use for my WoW. There's little trays in there that have different colored embossing powder already on them. So I keep them, and if I melt another color that's similar, I just use the same trays. But I haven't done that in a while, so I want to get into that again, but I haven't yet. And then see, here's my swatch book and my ATC books from the people that sent me ATC. Yeah, the black one, that's the document folder, has my foils in there. And then there's a red box that has all my patterns for boxes. And then beads and my 12x12 paper. That's the only ones I kept because I make boxes and gift cards, gift treats and treat boxes, treat bags, whatever you want to call them. So they were more important. And that green flappy thing that you see is actually a record holder. And I had 5 or 6 because before they used to live in my Billy. And Billy is not as deep as this shelving unit is. See, so they would stick out, and then I put them in those old record holders, and it would just be fine. But then I shuffled stuff around in the house, and I got this one for in here, and it fits 12x12 paper perfectly. But then it was a bit of a hassle to go through 5 or 6 or 7 of those record suitcases to find the one that you wanted. So I put them in here. I might change my mind again, but for now they live in here. And then there's stuff on top that I need to sort out and were in, you know, goodie bags and stuff like that. And my scoreboards and the little tub next to it has a bit of giveaway stuff, but also leftovers from workshops and make and takes that I need to, you know, pick through and take out the stuff that I can reuse, and then see what I do with the other bits. Like, you know, if you got a frame for a shaker card and yeah, you have 20 left, you might have to make a lot of shaker cards. So I probably don't want to do that. But then this is just a shelving unit from IKEA as well. They changed the name, so I don't know what it's called anymore. It used to be Gold Gorm, but it's not anymore. But it's the extra deep one, so I can fit in my computer and paper and printers. I have a normal one and a laser printer. This is my my camera for my markers. Actually, it looks like a camera bag, it's not. And this is my little card. It was half price compared to the rest grog, so I got this one. And also more of those little, and Vibra had them as well, compartment cases, and they fit 2 drops and these pigment inks perfectly. So I have Versamagic, Memento 2 drops and the Card Deco 2 drops and a box for my cats. It usually sits on top. But then, yeah, that's my room. And the computer that I use for editing, of course. And this is my memos. This is where I organize my videos per day or per week. So I won't show you that because then you know what's coming. But I have 3 rows, Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursdays, and then I put little sheets of paper on there. And I have a different desk, so the mostly things that have changed is that now I have a nice shelving unit instead of a rickety one that was before. And that worked fine, but and now it all kind of fits together. That I like that. And I don't have to be worried that it falls over. And this is my filming desk, where I usually make my cards. And that white shelving that you see is also from IKEA. It's a lock, L-A-C-K. And yeah, see, I didn't clean their stuff on the floor. I use those little carpets to keep my feet warm. But this is a CD holder that I put on the side, and it has little cubbies now, so I can put all the things I need, like distressings and stem cleaners and foam tape, card bases, enamel dots, and my heat gun is hanging on the side from my lock, and there's a little glass with all my rulers and scissors in there. And you can see this as my lighting. It's a daylight light. You can see it's different than before. There was LED before, you saw it was really yellow. And then there's a bit of paper in the front so it doesn't blind me, give me migraines. But when I film, I put my little, it's just a little camera that also makes movies. You know, it was the cheapest that did full HD. It's from Canon and it works great, but it doesn't have a flippable screen or anything like that. So what I do is I put a, well, let's say this is what I'm working on, and put that away. And then the shelf, I hacked a hole in there with my jigsaw, see, and that's why my camera lives in. It will film what I'm doing below, and then I have a contraption here that holds my mirror. The one I had before was better because it doesn't have that thing in the middle, but it kept falling over because it was top heavy. So now I'm trying this one out. It's really new and it seems to work, but yeah, it's actually supposed to hold your dishes, you know, your super pretty dishes. And then there's my Happy Meal wall. I need to find a better solution for that because I put them on with scotch tape and then they fall off. So I have more behind here. This needs to go. And then, yeah, they keep falling off. I keep sticking them back, but in the end, there's so much scotch tape on them that they don't look very nice anymore. Some are new, I still have to put up, but most of them just fall down after a while. And yeah, I want to keep them there. They keep me company during the year. It's Christmas card mostly and happy birthday cards and some swap cards. But yeah, I don't know. Their wardrobes, as I said, are from my clothes and also some remnants that don't fit in the kitchen. But yeah, might have to cover them with cork so I can pin them on there or something like that. I don't know yet, so I will figure that out. Might show you in the next craftroom tour. See, I like to display them because people made them for me and I like them. But yeah, if they fall on the floor, they fall on the floor and then they, yeah, that's not very nice. So, the drawers underneath my scanner cutter, you can see them in here. Hold the mats and stuff like that. And one drawer is actually empty. The other drawer has a bit of remnants from when I cleaned up my mom's apartment 3 years ago, I think. Yeah. There's still stuff I need to go through, but I open it and I see her photo and photos of my her grandchildren and my nephews, and then I just close it again. I think I will deal with that later. So, and you can see this is really, it's just a shelving unit for your TV. Actually, I think it was €9.95 in euros, so say $10. And the shelf that goes in the middle for your VCR, of course, I didn't put in because then I had to hack two holes in there. But then I screwed the tube lighting, and that also from IKEA. They don't sell them anymore because they switched to LED, and those LED ones are horrible. I don't know if they still sell them because they're called NON, non-buying them. I have those in the living room for my dishes and my crockware so I can show them, but there's no light coming out of them. And these are just fluorescent. You can buy them at a hardware store. I made sure I bought daylight colored tube lights, and that's basically it. There's all the things I need at hand. My stem positioner, stem cleaner, a little box with mounted foam tape, masking fluid, you know, stuff like that that I don't want to go look for, but I always put back and sometimes take them with me to workshops or make and takes, crops and stuff like that. And I really try to put them all back at the same time, because if I can't find things, I go, you know, really cranky, I think. And you see little pots with pens and my craft pick and card bases, paper towels, and behind the paper towels there's the box with enamel dots. And but the legs from the shelf are in the way a little bit sometimes, so I just have to move it around a little bit, but that's fine, you know, as long as it's empty. And that's basically my craft room. So I hope you like it and you have some idea of where I live and work. This is also where I take the photos for my cards, and because the lights are daylights, of course, I'll still use a flash more often than not, because see how dark it is where you don't see my house. It's, I keep the blinds closed because I don't want neighbors to peek inside. And yeah, you can see this is the craft sheets. I have a few different colors, I think about 15, and I can show you. I just put them, oh, my bin. Sorry. And these, I think they're 50 by 70 centimeters. I don't know what's that in feet, but you can buy them at the craft store. And they're really cheap. They're like 75 cents, maybe a dollar for dollar people. But yeah, you buy different colors and you can adapt them to your project. And I just put them underneath my lighting. Usually the other way around, so that white bit that is, I don't know what that is, but I think embossing paste or something like that. I just put something heavy on there. And on the other side, depends what's at hand. I just used that at this because I just made a card. But then I put my cards on there. Sorry, I'm trying to do this all in one hand. It's not very easy. And you can see the light gives shadow, but because it's fluorescent, it's very soft and minimal. And that's the best kind of light. And to take the picture, I just zoom in and then I use flash because it's, you know, almost nighttime. I think it was 4 o'clock, but my house is dark. And then I just crop whatever I don't want there, like, you know, the dishes. They don't need to be in the side, but then you have a really nice background. That's simple. I don't really like all the photos I see on Instagram with all the stuff around the flowers and beads and markers and whatnot. I want card so I can see what I have made, and I want attention given to it. So thank you for watching. I will see you again soon. Hope you enjoyed your tour, and well, until Tuesday. Bye.